Most people are unwitting liars. They are born into a world that has been carefully crafted for them by a deceptive group of psychopaths. This creation being the brainchild of a troop of maniacs who pretend to hold the best interest of the masses in high esteem. The tangled web of fabrications these sociopaths weave create an invisible gossamer with far-reaching threads throughout society. Filament tendrils designed to capture individual minds and confine them in an enormous collectivized holding cell which gives birth to a cozy panopticon teeming with hive-minded clones. This invisible prison distorts its captive's reality, causing them to unconsciously mimic those who invented this upside-down, inside-out existence. Due to this, a culture of pathological lying and involuntary psychopathy is deemed socially acceptable and normal. For those who can see at least part, if not all, of the ever-reaching gossamer, the evidence of its unrelenting predation is astoundingly abundant. No portion of life is left untouched by the intricately engineered fraud of the psychopaths. All media, including the news, television shows, movies, commercials, documentaries, magazines, social media networks, online information, books, bumper stickers, billboards, the list goes on, all of it is clutched within the web's delicate stranglehold. Religions are also wrapped in the cruel embrace of the silken lattice, being one of man's oldest methods of cognitive imprisonment. Politics, a different form of superstition, also plays an enormous role in the lacework of cerebral chains. Compulsory public schooling can easily be considered a contemporary domineering religion, indoctrinating the youth with the belief that government is their omniscient, benevolent god to be worshipped and obeyed without question. The resulting collectivized mentally shackled automatons unthinkingly imitate those who have maliciously enslaved them, and the cycle regrettably perseveres for numerous generations. As this rhythm continues over millennia, and the lunatics maintain a veiled manipulation over the intellect of the common people, the resulting human formations witnessed on this beautiful planet are nightmarish. Slavery, war, genocide, famine, poverty, homelessness, mental illness, depression. Is this really what being human is supposed to look like? Granted, the insane degenerates who currently rule the world through violence and coercion wish for every mind ensnared within the translucent gossamer to believe all humanity consists of nothing but depravity and warmongering. However, is that truly the case, or do these large-scale societal ills and atrocities come about because the institution created by the psychopaths is calling the shots for humanity? That institution being government. As Aldous Huxley in Brave New World Revisited said, the real hopeless victims of mental illness are to be found among those who appear to be most normal. Many of them are normal because they are so well adjusted to our mode of existence, because their human voice has been silenced so early in their lives that they do not even struggle or suffer or develop symptoms as the neurotic does. They are normal not in what may be called the absolute sense of the word. They are normal only in relation to a profoundly abnormal society. Their perfect adjustment to that abnormal society is a measure of their mental sickness. These millions of abnormally normal people living without fuss in a society to which, if they were fully human beings, they ought not to be adjusted.